Hello friends, how are you all? I hope you all are fine and in high spirits. Students, today we are going to study a new chapter from class 5, that is Mapping Your Way. So let's start. First of all, I want to tell you about an incident. Recently, I was going for some work from my school in an auto. After covering some distance, the auto driver said to me, "Sir, I don't know the way exactly. You please tell me." Hearing his words, I got a little nervous because I myself did not know the correct way. The auto driver asked a few people about the way to my destination, but nobody was able to tell correctly. I was getting late because the office would close at 5 p.m. All of a sudden, I remembered that why not take help from Google Map. I asked the auto driver to stop so that I could search on my phone. After searching for some time, I found the correct way. And I realized that we were on a totally wrong road at that time. So I told the auto driver to follow what I tell him, and then he first got to the right road, and then I could easily reach the office. So students, did you see? I used Google Map to find my exact location as well as my destination. And all this got possible because of the map. You see, these maps are so helpful to us. With the help of maps, we can easily find out the destination where we have to reach as well as the correct path to that destination. In this chapter, we will study how maps help us in different ways. Ashi is going to India Gate to see the Republic Day parade with the other children of her school. As you know, India celebrates 26th January as Republic Day because on this day, the Constitution of India was implemented. Ashi also went to India Gate to witness the parade with her friends. As the children settled down, they heard something about India Gate on the loudspeaker. The president is taking salute from the parade. To the right of the president is the India Gate. This was built in memory of the Indian soldiers who died in the First World War. There are lots of people sitting on both sides of Rajpath, that is the main road along which the parade passes. Rajpath is the main road which leads from India Gate to the Rashtrapati Bhavan. If we need to understand the map properly, which is taken with the help of satellite, let's see the map where every road from India Gate to Rashtrapati Bhavan and all places around is shown. Now we are seeing the map. Students, you can easily see in the picture where is India Gate, but now we have to find it in the map. Here is the map, and see, as you can see, these two small circles here. Out of these, the smaller circle is India Gate. Here you see, this point is exactly the location of India Gate. Now we will match the map and the photo. Have you seen a map of a city? I'm sure you might have seen many maps in your classes and on TVs also. Look at map 1. Match it with the photo and find out the names of roads that you will cross on your way from Rashtrapati Bhavan to India Gate. See, this is the Rashtrapati Bhavan, and if we have to go from Rashtrapati Bhavan towards India Gate, we have to cross Rafi Mark, Janpath and Man Singh Road. So these roads we have to cross while going from Rashtrapati Bhavan towards India Gate. You can see all these roads on the map. Okay, now students, can you find National Stadium in the map? See, in the picture you won't be able to see the National Stadium, but in the map there it is. This is the National Stadium, as it is clearly written here. Now let's see this central hexagon. If we zoom in to look more closely at one part of the map, it looks like this. And as you can see, this is a hexagon. This is called a hexagon. As you can see, it has 6 vertices, and each vertex leads to a road. So that is why this is known as the central hexagon. In the yellow picture or the yellow area, you can see 6 vertices which lead to 6 different roads. Now you will look at the map very carefully and let's answer the following questions. See carefully and tell if you are walking on Rajpath, then after India Gate, on which side would Children's Park be? Now student, if you are walking on Rajpath, this is Rajpath, after India Gate, on what side will the Children's Park be? It will be on the right side. Now see, if from Rashtrapati Bhavan towards India Gate and after India Gate, you will see that the Children's Park is on the right side. Next one is, which of these roads make the biggest angle between them? First, Man Singh Road and Shah Jahan Road, or Ashoka Road and Man Singh Road, or Janpath and Rajpath? Students, let's first see Man Singh Road and Shah Jahan Road. As you can see here, this is the intersection of Man Singh Road and Shah Jahan Road, and you can clearly see that the angle made here is less than 90 degrees, and we can verify it with the DC. So this is less than 90 degrees, so this is an acute angle. Then we see Ashoka Road and Man Singh Road. Here you are, Ashoka Road, this and this Man Singh Road. The angle formed between these two roads at their point of intersection, as you can see, this is greater than 90 degrees. So this is obtuse angle. And the third one is Janpath and Rajpath. So students, here you see, this is Janpath and Rajpath. This is the point of intersection. And here, what kind of angle do these make? They are making a right angle. So the question was, which of these roads make the biggest angle between them? So the answer is Man Singh Road and Ashoka Road, as they are making an obtuse angle, which is greater than acute angle as well as the right angle. Waiting for the parade. While waiting for the parade, Kancha and some of his friends wonder where this parade ends. Kancha is carrying a newspaper in which the route of the parade is written. The parade starts from Vijay Chowk, then it leads to Rajpath, India Gate, Tilak Mark, B.S. Zafar Mark, Subhash Mark, and then Red Fort. The children look at this map to see the parade route. Now, look at the map very carefully and you see that which of these is the longest road, B.S. Zafar Mark, Subhash Mark or Tilak Mark. Now students, the map is in front of you. I leave this question for you to answer. You have to see the map very carefully and find out which amongst these is the longest road. Now students, one child's mother told him that the distance from Vijay Chowk to India Gate and then to Rajpath is 2 kilometers, and you see on the map it is only 4 centimeters long. What does it mean? 4 centimeters on map is actually equal to 2 kilometers on the earth or on the land. And according to this, 2 centimeters on the map will be equal to 1 kilometer on the land. As you can see, this is also written as the scale on the map, that is 2 centimeters equals 1 kilometer. So students, what is the meaning of scale? Scale means that a comparatively bigger piece of land is represented as a smaller area on the map, but both are in proportion. So that proportion is represented as scale, as in this map it's written 2 centimeters equal 1 kilometer. It means 2 centimeters on map represents 1 kilometer on the actual land. So this way, seeing a map, you can easily calculate the actual distance between two places. As the parade passes by, they see some children coming on an elephant. These children have got bravery awards. Bravery awards are given to children who have shown some act of bravery to save other people's lives. They also enjoy the colorful dances and aerobics by school children. Now, these students want to follow the parade to Red Fort. A child, Gappu, has seen Red Fort before and tells them about his trip. When we reached Red Fort, there was a long queue for tickets. The main entrance of the Red Fort is called Lahori Gate. After entering Lahori Gate, we turned left into a long corridor with little shops on both sides. This is called the famous Meena Bazaar. Gappu told that he bought some bangles from there for his sister. You can go straight through Nakkar Khana and reach Diwan-e-Am, that is Diwan-e-Am. Walking straight from Diwan-e-Am, we saw Rang Mahal. It is a beautiful building. There were three more buildings on the left side. Can you look at these on the map? Here you are. You can see these three buildings on the left side of the Rang Mahal. On the left side of Rang Mahal, there is Diwane Khas, where the king used to meet his ministers and the important people of his dynasty. Now, students, you have to look at map 4 very carefully. The scale given is 1 centimeter equals 100 meters. So, what does it mean? That 1 centimeter on map represents 100 meters on actual land. Now, students, can you answer these questions on the basis of this map? Let's find out. Which of these is nearer to river Yamuna, the Diwan-e-Am or the Diwan-e-Khas? Now, let's look at the map. Now, see which one is more close to river Yamuna, Diwan-e-Khas or Diwan-e-Am. This is Yamuna River, and as you can clearly see, Diwan-e-Khas is more close to the river Yamuna. So, the correct answer is Diwan-e-Khas. Next question is, between which two buildings is Aramgah? Now, students, have a look at the map very carefully and you can see the Aramgah is between these two buildings. This one is Diwan-e-Khas and this one is Rang Mahal. So, Aramgah is between Diwan-e-Khas and Rang Mahal. Next question is, which buildings do you pass while going from Rang Mahal to the Hammam? Now, students, see carefully. This is the Rang Mahal and this is the Hammam. So, you will cross Aramgah and Diwan-e-Khas to reach Hammam from Rang Mahal. You will cross Aramgah and the Diwan-e-Khas. Next question is, dear students, let's learn something more about reading the map by looking at Ashish school map. Here you are. Ashish school looks like this from the top. As you can see, this is the map of Ashish school. These are classrooms. Here is the playground. This is the main gate of the school. This is school's office area, the garden, assembly ground, and the hall. Now, looking at this map, let's try to find out answers to some questions. How many times bigger is the area of the assembly ground than that of the office? Now, let's find the area of the assembly ground. As you can see, the assembly ground, let's count the number of squares in the assembly ground. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9, 10, 11, 12, 13, 14 and 15. So, the assembly ground has 15 equal squares. And let's see how many squares does the office have? 1, 2 and 3. The office has only 3 squares. So, students, it's clearly seen that 15 is 5 times 3. So, this means the assembly ground is having an area 5 times bigger than that of the office. That is, the area of assembly ground is 5 times bigger than that of the office. Now see, all the classrooms in Ashish's school look like this. In the classroom, here is the main door. This is the blackboard and the display board at the end of the class. The notice board on the right side, windows on the left and Almira at the back towards the left. And these are benches placed in the classroom. Now look carefully and find out which of these is exactly opposite to the blackboard. Is it Almira or windows? Or notice board or display board. So as you can see in the map, just opposite to blackboard at the end is display board, which is just opposite the blackboard. So the correct answer is display board. Let's look at the school map again and find out, can a child sitting in class 3A see the playground? Now see the school map again and find out, the child who is sitting in class 3A, this is class 3A here and this is the playground, but there are 3 rooms between the playground and the class 3A. So a child sitting in class 3A will not be able to see the playground. Now few students might feel that it is good that you can't see the playground from the classroom so that you can concentrate more on studies. But a child who is not finding a lot of interest in the classroom, he might be thinking that maybe if I would be able to see the playground, I would enjoy myself. But students, when you are in the class, you should focus on what the teacher is teaching you. Let's find out which of these would have the smallest area. The garden, assembly ground or the hall. Now let's see. The hall has, let's count the number of squares in all of these. First one is the hall. As you can count, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9 and 10. So the hall has 10 square units. So the hall has 10 squares. Assembly ground, as we counted it earlier, the assembly ground had 15 squares. Now let's count the number of squares in the garden. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, 8, 9. 10, 11, 12, 13, 14, 15, 16, 17, 18, 19, 20, 21, 22, 23, small part is missing, 24 and 25. So approximately 25 squares we have, from which a little bit of area is missing. Now, so clearly we can see the garden has the biggest area and which of these is having the smallest area? The hall. The hall is having the smallest area. So students, this way you can read any map and find the distance between two places, or you can also find the areas of different buildings or pieces of land. Students, now let's see the map of India. This is India's political map. You can see a state whose name is Madhya Pradesh. Now, students, can you find out which other states share their boundary with this state, that is Madhya Pradesh? Now look at the map carefully. Which other states share their boundary with Madhya Pradesh? I'm leaving this question for you. I hope you will be able to find out all the states whose boundaries are shared with Madhya Pradesh. I'm sure with the help of this chapter, you will be able to study maps in your future very easily. Thank you.